The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Good morning and welcome to Crossroads Presbyterian Church for worship today. Whether it is your first time or your first time in a long time, welcome home. And for those that are joining us by live stream worship this morning, it is good to have you worshiping with us as well. As we continue to regather as a congregation, we are all in different places with different needs. And so face coverings are optional. For our children and youth ministries, they're still required as those populations have not yet had access to the vaccine. And we'll continue to be respectful of one another as we come together in God's love. There are a few changes to worship beyond social distancing today. We have a card in your pew rack in front of you, a welcome card, and this is replacing our pew pad for this season. So we ask that every family fill one out, just with your name, those worshiping with you. On the back side, there are opportunities to connect. So if you'd like to know more about different aspects of our ministry, please feel free to check one of those boxes. There are also places to mark a prayer concern or a joy. For those worshiping at home or on live stream today, if you are a visitor with us, simply email visitor@crossroadspres.org or email your prayer concern or joy to prayers@crossroadspres.org. Summer is here, and we are planning a variety of fellowship and worship opportunities on Wednesday evenings outdoors starting June 23rd. Join us on June 23rd for our summer kickoff. Grab dinner from that Taco Guy food truck from 5 to 7. Bring your camp chair and a blanket and stay for our 30-minute Vespers service. And in between, if you need to let go of the stress from the day, join Anna Adi for an outdoor yoga session at 6 p.m. We hope Wednesday nights will be a wonderful time for our community to regather and experience fellowship. And now I'd like to invite forward Family Promise CEO Kathleen Christensen Fisher, as well as our hospitality coordinator, Marilyn Mullen, or Chef M, for a minute for mission.
So good morning, Crossroads. I appreciate the opportunity to thank you for your unyielding support of the Family Promise's mission to end homelessness in Ozaukee County. Since 2015, you have opened your doors to children and families at risk of homelessness in our community. Hundreds of volunteers provided thousands of hours and many meals to families in our program. As you know, COVID turned our lives upside down. And for Family Promise, it meant we had to find an alternative option for sheltering due to the congregation's inability to serve our families. We turned to a local motel for overnight shelter and have had 10 rooms filled ever since. Within a few weeks of using the motel, we realized how difficult it would be to prepare meals for a family in a motel. We reached out to our community for ideas, and we're so grateful when Crossroads stepped up to offer Marilyn's time to prepare meals for our guests. Marilyn has prepared unbelievably awesome meals Tuesday through Friday since April of 2020. There are so many stories of gratitude, but one jumps out that I'd like to share. Last fall, Port Washington Police Department came to our office asking for assistance with a young man sleeping in his car at a local park and ride. He was working and trying to lose weight so that he could enroll in the Marines. His goal was to lose 40 pounds. We took him into the shelter, and for 90 days in our program, he worked, exercised, and limited his meals to the one hot meal that Marilyn prepared for him each day. We recently learned from his recruiter that he exceeded his weight loss goal and is officially enlisted. This is a true testament to Marilyn's dedication to preparing quality meals for our guests. From chicken kebabs to hamburger night, Marilyn stepped up when so many had to step back. This morning, I wanted to thank Crossroads for your continuing your support during a challenging time, and Marilyn for your outstanding service to Family Promise. We are sad that your services are ending, but happy to know that the Crossroads volunteers will continue the meal program for households at the motel. I do have one bit of good news to share. Family Promise was awarded a $1.8 million grant to develop a shelter in Ozaukee County. The congregations have already agreed to continue their volunteer meal program in the new shelter. We plan to have it open in spring of 2022. Until then, we will continue to work together to help children and their families during these very tough times. Thanks so much to all of you, and especially Marilyn, thank you.
Thank you. What a testimony to the impact Crossroads has been able to have throughout the pandemic. Although we worship in different spaces this morning, we do worship together in spirit and in truth. So as we prepare to hear from God today, let us take a moment to center ourselves on our worship series theme. Simple phrases that sound Christian, like they could be found in Scripture. They capture an element of truth, but these words miss the point in important ways. We want our faith to be established on the truth that is found in the Word of God and in the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ. So let's sing together.
Ancient words ever true, changing me, changing you. We have come with open hearts, oh let the ancient words impart.
When we hear God said it, I believe it, that settles it. We must remember God's word.
Be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves.
When we hear, God needed another angel, we must remember God's word.
Jesus came that we may have life and have it abundantly.
When we hear the call to fight for the kingdom, we must remember God's word.
Live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us.
Would you please stand and let us worship God, whose promises never fail?
Ancient,
here we go.
Ancient words ever true, changing me, changing you. We have come with open hearts, oh let the ancient words impart. Oh let the ancient words impart.
Let us continue to worship God in song, whose promises never fail.
Here in this place, the new light is streaming. Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space our fears and our dreamings, brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in the lost and forsaken. Gather us in the blind and the lame. Call to us now and we shall awaken. Shall arise at the sound of your name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light in the whole human race. Gather us in the rich and the haughty, gather us in the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly, give us the courage to enter the song.
Please bow together in prayer. God of all creation, you see us here before you, asking to be gathered together, unified as your church. You know our hearts, the ones that hold bitterness, anger, and resentment towards other people and even towards you. You know our thoughts, the ones that tear apart the integrity of those around us. You know our actions, the ones that promote our own interests instead of the needs of others. Forgive us our sins, Lord. We, your gathered people, desire your mercy and your grace, so that we can serve you as the body of Christ. Amen.
In the Gospel of John, Jesus tells Nicodemus that God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Friends, hear and believe the good news of the gospel.
In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us sing together of Christ's sacrifice for us.
Here we will take the wine and the water. Here we will take the bread of new birth. Here you shall call your sons and your daughters. Anew to be salt for the earth. Give us to drink the wine of compassion. Give us to eat the bread that is you. Nourish us well and teach us to fashion lives that are holy and hearts that are true. Buildings confining, not in some heaven light years away. Here in this place the new light is shining. Now is the kingdom and now is the day. Gather us in and hold us forever. Gather us in and make us your own. Gather us in, all peoples together.
As we have been reminded of God's saving grace, let us extend the peace of Christ from our seats as we wave and say words of greeting to one another. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another and share the peace of Christ.
Share your grace and show forth your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, we pray. Amen. Our passage for today is from the Gospel of Luke chapter 5, verses 17 through 26. This story comes to us at the very beginning of Jesus' ministry in the Gospel of Luke. Prior to this, he has already healed several people, the man with the unclean spirit and others. And his reputation is starting to precede him as a healer and a teacher. Hear God's word for us this morning. One day, while Jesus was teaching, Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting nearby. They had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and from Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal. Just then some men came, carrying a paralyzed man in a bed. They were trying to bring him in and lay him before Jesus, but finding no way to bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and let him down with his bed through the tiles into the middle of the crowd in front of Jesus. When he saw their faith, he said, "Friends, your sins are forgiven you." Then the scribes and the Pharisees began to question, "Who is this? Who is speaking blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus perceived their questionings, he answered them, "Why do you raise such questions in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven you,' or to say, 'Stand up and walk'? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the one who was paralyzed, "I say to you, stand up and take your bed and go to your home." Immediately he stood up before him, took what he had been lying on, and went to his home, glorifying God. Amazement seized all of them, and they glorified God and were filled with awe, saying, "We have seen strange things today." Friends in Christ, this is the word of the Lord. Well, we're wrapping up our half-truth series today, and today's half-truth is God needed another angel. There's a beautiful book written decades ago to answer this half-truth. It's called Lament for a Son, and it's written by Nicholas Walterstorff, who is a Christian philosopher. He's world-renowned for his intellect. He's taught at Yale. He's advised leaders around the world, and he's human. Nicholas's son died tragically as a young adult while hiking in Europe. It was an accident. He was at the prime of his life. And Nicholas wrote this book because he kept hearing these half-truths. God needed another angel. Nicholas knew friends were well-meaning, but he dug deep into his faith, into his intellect, and he wrote this beautiful book. He writes that to love is to suffer. Suffering is part of our human condition. He goes on, "We all suffer, for we all prize and love. And in this present existence of ours, present prizing and loving yield suffering. Love in our world is suffering love. Some do not suffer much, though, for they do not love much. Suffering is for the loving. This," said Jesus, "is the command of the Holy One. You shall love your neighbor as yourself." And so in commanding us to love, God invites us to suffer. Have you considered that before? In commanding us to love, God invites us to suffer. God doesn't invite us to be invincible, but to be vulnerable. And one aspect of suffering is to tap into our vulnerability. Indeed, we all know that when you love deeply, there will be hurt and pain. And so today, from our Gospel of Luke, we have a powerful message about a man who is hurting and in pain. The paralytic is suffering, he cannot walk, and he has some tremendous friends who go to great lengths to love him deeply. In our passage, these friends hear that Jesus is teaching in the town of Capernaum. A crowd has gathered. It's filled up this little house. Jesus already has a reputation as a healer, as a teacher. His identity as Messiah is not yet revealed. He's at the beginning of his ministry. And these friends, they hear this news, and they have to take their suffering friend to Jesus. This is one of many stories of healing in the gospel. For Jesus is a man, the Son of God, concerned with healing. He's been brought to earth to provide reconciliation and love in the face of death and destruction. So what do we see in our passage for today? We see a God who is seeking to mend, to heal, to repair, to forgive. So what does this story have to do with our half-truth? God needed another angel? Today's half-truth actually has no truth in it. This phrase is typically said to offer comfort to a parent like Nicholas. It's said in the face of tragedy, usually at the death of a child, but it does harm. And it starts first with a really skewed, poor understanding of God. God needed. Friends, God doesn't need anything. This implies that there's a God up in heaven looking to be satiated like some ogre. And that's a pagan view of God, which was at work at that time. But it's not the God we learn about in Scripture. Now for the rest of the phrase, another angel. Also bad theology. Because we know when we die, we don't become angels. We do go to heaven. We are made new creations. But angels were created by God. Matthew 22, verse 30 and Luke 20, 36 talk about how angels were created by God to be messengers, and there's a set number of them. They come throughout Scripture to give messages to God's people, to call God's people into a calling. Remember Gabriel coming to Mary? When we die, we don't go and become an angel. We join the angels up in heaven. Again, when we hear this half-statement, we've got to weigh it against what we know about God. Which takes me back to our story today from Luke. Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us. We learn something about the character of God in today's story. Today we learn that Jesus has the power to heal and forgive sins, that Jesus' ministry is about restoration, and primarily about forgiveness. Before Jesus even heals the paralytic, he forgives his friends. I find it interesting that as the crowd was gathering, they could have asked Jesus anything. They could have asked him for power or wealth. But what's most interesting about the Gospels and Jesus' ministry is that everybody who runs to him is looking to be healed. They're sick. They're possessed by demons. They're needing forgiveness. There are 41 stories of healing in the gospel. We heard in our assurance of pardon today earlier that God loves us so much that he sent his son to live, to heal, to minister, to die, to rise again, so that we would have life. Life in our front pew today, friends. This is quite the opposite of a God who needs another angel, isn't it? The God of Scripture, Jesus Christ, is a God who wants to bring mending and repair and healing. So in the face of unspeakable loss or grief, we might take a lesson from Jesus and sit with those friends who are grieving. And in case we forget what this reconciling love means, today, friends, we have two sacraments. Our only two in the Presbyterian Church. And our sacraments are signs and seals of God's abundance, of God's reconciling love, of God's desire to do a new thing and to bring about life. So in the face of suffering, may you, like the paralytic's friends, encounter a God and a community of faith that seeks to hold you up, to support you, and to bring about healing and life. And in case you forget, today we have a baptism and we get to come to the table of God's grace. In the name of our Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer of us all, amen. And now I'd like to invite forward all of those participating in today's baptism.
Friends, hear the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. And so obeying the word of our Lord Jesus and confident in his promises, we baptize those whom God has called. In baptism, God claims us and seals us to show that we belong to God. God frees us from sin and death, uniting us with Jesus Christ in his death and resurrection. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are made members of the church, the body of Christ, and joined to Christ's ministry of love, peace, and justice. And so let us remember with joy our own baptisms this morning as we celebrate the sacrament.
Good morning. My name is Hindi Steck, and I am an elder serving here at Crossroads. On behalf of the session, it is with great joy that I present Ada Grace Mills, daughter of Jeremy and Allison Mills, to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Allison and Jeremy, do you desire that Ada be baptized? Relying on God's grace, do you promise to live the Christian faith and teach that to your daughter?
Do you, as members of the Church of Jesus Christ, promise to guide and nurture Ada by word and deed with love and prayer?
We do.
Will you encourage her to know and follow Christ and to be a faithful member of his church?
We will.
Through the sacrament of baptism, we enter the covenant that God has established in Jesus Christ. Within this covenant, God gives us new life, strengthens us to resist evil, and nurtures us in love. Through this sacrament, we covenant to serve Christ and turn away from evil and turn toward Jesus Christ. So Allison and Jeremy, trusting in the gracious mercy of God, do you turn from the ways of sin and renounce evil and power in its world? If so, say, I do. And who is your Lord and Savior? Will you be Christ's faithful disciple, obeying his word and showing his love? If so, say, I will, with God's help.
With the whole church, let us stand and confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. Let us now give thanks to God for the gift of water which sustains all living things. Let us pray. Holy God, with the gift of water, you sustain all living things. In the beginning of time, your Spirit moved over the chaos and called forth life. In the time of Noah, you destroyed evil by the waters of the flood, giving a new beginning. You led Israel out of slavery through the waters of the sea, and in the waters of the Jordan, Jesus was baptized by John and anointed with your Holy Spirit. By the baptism of his own death and resurrection, Christ set us free from sin and death and opened the way to eternal life. And so send your Spirit to move over this water this day, that it would be a fountain of deliverance and rebirth. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon Ada, that she would have the power to do your will and continue forever in the risen life of Christ. To you be all praise, honor, and glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, through the power of the Holy Spirit, and through the gift of our Father who is Creator. Amen. What is the Christian name of your child?
Ada Grace Mills.
Ada Grace. I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, three in one. Let's pray together. O Lord, uphold Ada by your Holy Spirit. Give her a spirit of wisdom and understanding, a spirit of counsel and might, a spirit of joy and love for you, both now and forevermore. Ada, child of the covenant, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. Ada has been received into the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church by the power of the Holy Spirit, and she is now a member of Christ's family. With joy and thanksgiving, we welcome her into the body of Christ. And it wouldn't be a celebration without some presents. At this time, Deacon Deb Wolf has gifts on behalf of the congregation to help Ada remember her baptism. This is your family. Yeah. You say hi? They're your church family. Congratulations.
Well, friends, in gratitude, we offer our lives to God in the things we do and in the gifts that we share. And on this Sunday, we're especially aware that God meets our physical needs, giving us food to nourish our bodies, even as the Lord's table nourishes our souls. And on Communion Sundays, we often grab a grocery bag from the cart in the narthex and return it filled with supplies for the food pantry at Family Sharing. Please remember to continue sending your tithes and offerings to the church by mailing your checks or giving online or even texting. And you can put your tithes and gifts and welcome cards in the offering baskets as you exit the sanctuary this morning. So now let us praise God with thanksgiving for all God's good gifts as we stand and sing the doxology together.
Pray. Compassionate God, we offer you these gifts as signs of our time and labor. Receive the offering of our lives and feed us with your grace that in the midst of death, all creation might feast on your unending life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
As we come to Christ's table together here in person and online, we are mindful of those worshiping at home. Those at home might want to prepare their elements right now. Friends, this is the joyful feast of the kingdom of God. We know from Scripture that they will come from north and south and east and west and sit at God's table in the kingdom of God. This is not a Crossroads table or a Presbyterian Church USA table, but this is the Lord's table. And our Lord and Savior invites all those who wish to follow him to come to this table of abundant grace.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God our thanks and praise.
Friends, let us pray. It is with joy that we give you thanks and praise, Almighty and everlasting God. You created the heavens and the earth, and you sustain us each day. Truly, we are blessed, yet you have revealed the fullness of your love in sending into the world your Son, Jesus Christ, for us and for our salvation. By his life, we learn to walk according to his purposes. By his death, sin's power over us has been broken. By his resurrection, we too may share in life eternal. Holy One, as we share this meal as the family of God, we remember Christ's perfect sacrifice on the cross. We experience afresh our connection to all who claim Christ as Lord. We taste the life that is truly life, and we look with anticipation to Christ's return. So send your Holy Spirit upon us, we pray, that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be to us the communion of the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Grant that, being joined together in him, we may attain to the unity of the faith and grow up in all things into Christ our Lord. As we come to this table, remember those who are hungry in body or in spirit. We thank you for the ministry of Chef Marilyn as she has fed so many children and families who have been home insecure during the pandemic especially. Refresh her with your grace, we pray, and reveal to her a glimpse of the difference her meals have made in creating a sense of home. May the churches of Ozaukee County now take up this mantle to feed others in your name. Now, as this grain has been gathered from many fields into one loaf, and these grapes from many hills into one cup, grant, O Lord, that your whole church may soon be gathered from the ends of the earth and into your kingdom. Come, Lord Jesus, come. And now, as our Savior Jesus Christ has taught us, let us pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
On the night of Jesus' arrest, he sat at the table with his disciples, with those who would betray him, those who would deny him, and those who would follow him. And to each of them, he took a loaf of bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he said, "Take, eat, this is my body broken for all of you. Every time you eat this, remember me."
And in the same way, after supper, Jesus took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink of it, do this in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's saving death until, friends, he will come again."
We will share communion today with our individual servings. If you've not yet received one, please raise your hand and the servers will bring one to you. Carefully peeling back the top clear label, we can access our bread. Jesus Christ, the bread of heaven. Peeling back the second layer with patience. God's grace is a gift given to all. It's just hard to access today, huh? That's a half-truth. God's grace is always there. I will partake later. The cup of salvation. And now let us sing together and reflect on Christ's sacrifice for us.
Behold the Lamb who bears our sins away, slain for us. And we remember the promise made that all who come in faith find forgiveness at the cross. So we share in this bread of life, and we drink of his sacrifice as a sign of our bonds of peace around the table of the King. The body of our Savior Jesus Christ, torn for you. Eat and remember the wounds that heal, the death that brings us life. Pay the price to make us one. So we share in this bread of life, and we drink of his sacrifice as a sign of our bonds of love around the table of the King. The blood that cleanses every stain of sin shed for you. Drink and remember the drink that's cup that all may enter in to receive the life of God. So we share in this bread of life, and we drink of his sacrifice as a sign of our of grace around the table of the King.
Let us pray together. God, what a joy it is to come together around your table, a King's table, a reconciling table. Thank you for this gift of the sacrament which nourishes us. May we leave ready to serve you and to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Let us now stand to sing and continue worshiping Christ.
And so with thankfulness and faith we rise to respond and to remember our call to follow in the steps of Christ as his body here on earth. As we
Friends, what a joy it was to celebrate the baptism of Ada and to come to God's table of grace. So now receive this charge. Go out into God's world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return to no one evil for evil, but strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the suffering. Honor all persons. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the abundant blessing of the Holy Spirit, go with us all. Amen. Please be.
And so with thankfulness and faith we rise to respond and to remember our call to follow in the steps of Christ as his body here on earth. Suffering, we proclaim Christ will come again and will join in the feast of heaven around the table of the King as we share. Around the table of the King.